In the quiz, we analyzed the stability of the forward Euler method. Now we introduce some changes to turn the forward Euler method into the backward Euler method. This method is called an implicit solver. We are going to see why. The backward Euler method works like this. To go from the initial value of x to the value after the first step, it added the step size times the rate of change at time zero. The backward Euler method works with the rate of change at the end of the first step, x of h, actually our estimate of the rate of change at the end of the first step. Keep in mind that I'm writing x of h, but I'm referring to my estimates, the numerical solution, not the exact solution. This means that the value at the end of the first steps appears on the left-hand side and on the right-hand side. This is why this is called an implicit method. We have to solve for x of h. It's hidden in this equation. It's not explicit. So let's solve for x of h. Bring this term over to the left-hand side. Then we have x at the end of the first step plus time step times constant times x at the end of the first step equals the initial value. We can factor out x of h and find that x of h equals the initial value divided by 1 plus hk. This is something like 1 over 1 plus 100 if we choose a really large h, which would be 1 over 101. If you form powers of these, they are going to decay pretty quickly and there is no oscillation whatsoever. So we have no problem at all with this expression. It's always going to work, no matter how large the step size is. This is very handy when one tries to solve stiff differential equations.